morning, ladies and gentlemen. With the topic today, I'd like to start with talking about lifelong learners' characteristics. I think lifelong learner characteristics are very important in being a good teacher, being a good learner, and that can be instilled in all kinds of people, whether they are teachers, students, or people in general. Characteristics of lifelong learners could be a knowledge, a change maker. I think this is the most important characteristic. If you are a change maker, you will be willing to learn and you will be willing to seek knowledge all the time. As a change maker, you can make changes within yourself, within your peripheral, within your atmosphere, within your classroom, as well as making changes or inspiring changes in others, especially your students, people around you, people in your family, for example. As a knowledge seeker, we continually seek learning experiences or opportunities to improve the knowledge and skills that we have. And that is part of the change maker. Because if you continue seeking knowledge or new ideas, you will improve your work all the time. You will improve your teaching. If you are a teacher, you will improve your learning. If you are a learner or a student, you will improve your work. If you are an employee or a manager or an administrator or a businessman. As a social learner, you learn both from and with others. That means that you are open to others' ideas and knowledge. You are not confined with only what you have searched for or what you know already know. You are open to others' ideas as well. And in these days of technology, it is very easy in order to Google, to search for knowledge of others in order to add up to what we already know or what we already have learned. And that is what we should instill in our students as a teacher, to seek knowledge, to be a social learner, so that they can share what they learn with others. They are open to knowledge from their teachers as well as from their classmates, from their friends, from their family. As a critical thinker, a lifelong learner don't simply just take in information. You have to analyze, synthesize, and apply what you have learned to your situation. And this is very important because at the moment, I think one of the problems of our education is that our learners simply take in the information from what the teachers have preached. So we should give them the opportunities that knowledge is everywhere and is not confined only in the classroom. And the students, once getting the knowledge or learning a lesson, they should be able to criticize, to analyze, to evaluate whether the information they are given is worthwhile, is debatable, or is adaptable to their life or not. Also, as a, they are, apart from being a critical thinker, a lifelong learner should be willing to share. And that's very important. And by sharing, some of the, I think from the source that I have Googled, the word is used is a teacher. So whether you are an employee, a manager, an administrator, a teacher, or even a student, you can be a teacher. That is, you can share. You can share your knowledge. You can share your idea all the time. And that is you usually openly share what you know because you understand that having open networks actually gives you more access to the knowledge. So if you can build your network, the students among their classmates, or the teachers among teachers yourself, you can be a sharer of the knowledge as a lifelong learner. Also, you are a communicator. A lifelong learner usually communicate with others what you know, what you want to know, and what you have learned, and what you think about what you have learned. And you should be a good communicator with interpersonal skills that you should communicate as what you think, and you are open to others' opinions as well. And the last one is that lifelong learners never think of themselves as an expert, because learning is never ending. And as a lifelong learner, you usually, it's in your habit of learning, seeking for new information all the time. And as you all are here, it proves that you are a lifelong learner, because you seek the opportunities to get new information, to get new ideas regarding the teaching, regarding the education, and that's why you are all here. And so congratulate you all for being lifelong learners. And as lifelong learners, as I mentioned earlier, that as a lifelong learner, even the teachers or the students can be lifelong learners, and that can help as a teacher with their professional development, and as a learner, as a student being a learner, a lifelong learner, and that will help them with through their life. I would like to talk about three groups of people involved in distance learning via television, in distance learning in the work that I have been doing. The three people are the resource teachers, that is the teachers from the parent school or Wang Kraikawon school. The second group of teachers are the teachers in schools in remote areas where the distance learning television are provided in order to help them with their teaching. And the third group of people that I would like to talk about is the remote learners, remote students, students in those remote schools who are learning through distance learning television. And I would like to point out the changing roles of these groups of people according to the distance learning, when the distance learning television takes part in their lives, in their teaching and learning life, what happens to them. For those who don't have the background of what distance learning television is doing, I would like to give you a brief on the work. At the moment, in fact, during the last 20 years, the Distance Learning Foundation has provided distance learning television to schools all over the country. And basically, we provide grade 1 to 12 classes broadcast live from Wang Kraikawon School, which is a private school under His Majesty the King, to all schools over the country. And the schools, they only have to have the equipment, the receivers and the televisions and the satellite to receive the signal. And they, if they arrange the timetable according to the timetable of Wang Kraikawon School, they will be able to receive all the broadcast classes from grade 1 to 12. And this is to solve the teacher shortage problem. In most schools, especially small schools of the country, about 15,000 schools. There is a problem of teacher shortage, and that has been a problem for years for the kids that cannot be solved. And one of the alternatives to help solve this problem is to arrange for teaching and learning process through distance learning television. And that is where Distance Learning Foundation has a role in helping, in working with the Ministry of Education, the OBEC, to provide education through distance learning television. And as for the teachers of Wang Kreng Wun School, they realized that their role is kind of a model teacher for all teachers in remote areas. The teachers at Parent School or Wang Kreng Wun School find it very demanding. They have to make sure they deliver a good lesson that is useful to both the teachers and the students in remote schools. They have to make their teaching very interesting, very stimulating. They have to keep exploring and experimenting new ways of teaching, new teaching materials, and new activities to make the learners, as well as the teachers and the lessons, interesting. They have to plan the lesson, keeping in mind that they have more than 100,000 students in each class. Not only 40 or 50 students, not only the students in their classroom in the parent school only, but more than 100,000 students each time. They have to distribute the lesson plan to remote schools beforehand, and they have to plan the broadcast class with the technical team in order to make sure that the broadcast is smooth. And the resource teachers at the parent school, anyway, they never consider themselves the best teacher or the teacher model or the teacher trainer. They are willing to share their knowledge, and at the same time, they learn from remote school teachers. They share the lesson plans and teaching materials so that the teachers in remote schools can follow the broadcast lesson and facilitate their students. They also share teaching techniques and ideas via social media, and that's another technology as a supplement to the television, because the resource teachers and teachers in remote areas, they communicate through social media. However, the resource teachers have to keep improving their teaching and updating the teaching resources in order to keep the attention and interest of remote teachers as well as students in using the LTV. It can be said that the resource teachers never stop learning and consider their work as part of professional development. So I think that in this case, the resource teachers are qualified as a lifelong learner as well. So they never stop seeking knowledge or new skills or new techniques to share with the remote teachers. They are willing to share their knowledge, and they never stop being very helpful in promoting the teaching and learning and helping the teachers in remote schools. As for the teachers in remote schools, also what happens in the remote schools is that while using the LTV, some remote teachers might think that they do not have to do anything while the students are learning with the distance learning television. Some may switch on the television and then leave the class. In fact, the teachers in remote schools have to make preparations in order to get themselves and their students ready for the broadcast class. Therefore, the remote teachers have to be an efficient manager of learning arranging class time, arranging classroom, preparing the materials beforehand, and getting the students ready for the broadcast class. They have to go through the teacher's manual beforehand so that they know what is going on in the broadcast lesson. With their experience with remote students, because it's their own students, they have to be able to decide at what stage of broadcast lesson they should intervene to make sure that students understand and are able to follow the broadcast lesson without problem. So they have to prepare supplementary worksheets, give additional explanation, and even arrange extra classes for a follow-up in case their students have problems. In addition, they have to prepare supplementary worksheets and activities that correspond to their context and environment, which could be different from that of parent school. Because as you know, that from parent school, the resource teachers, they teach according to their lesson plan that fits the context of their school, that fits the context of their students. But in remote schools, it's a different context. So the teachers in remote schools, they have to adapt, they have to revise, they have to prepare some supplements in order to make it more practical for their students in their context. I would like to show this VTR of the teachers. Yes, these are the teachers in remote schools preparing the lesson plans. And they are there with the students in the class in order to help them while they are learning through the distance learning television. So you see the remote schools, they are active all the time. They have to facilitate the students, monitor the students, guide the students through the lesson on the television. They have to distribute the supplements that they download from the online or photocopy from the teacher's manual book. Since the remote teachers, they are not the main teacher, but more like a co-teacher or a facilitator, they will have more time to observe their students' performance individually and provide support case by case. They should write observation notes after each class indicating their students' performance, strengths and weaknesses, problems they encounter in class and how they deal with them. This would help them monitor and support each individual student more effectively. And this will not happen if the teachers in remote schools have to teach the class themselves. But in this case, they have the DLTV teachers, the resource teachers, teaching the class as the main teacher for them. So they have more time to make sure that each of their students understand what's going on in the lesson and help each student in their class through problems that they have found in learning. And as I said, that the remote teachers, they should make notes after each class indicating what has happened in each class regarding their students' performance, the problems and the solutions. And with that notes, the notes will serve as input for classroom research. And looking back in the past, teachers in remote areas, they don't have time to do that. So the observation notes could be kind of a platform for them to work more on the classroom research. And this is part of the professional development that can happen with the remote teachers. And similarly, the resource teachers as well, they can work on the research, classroom research as well, because in the resource school, in the parent school, the teachers have the same situation, teaching and learning process, where they find their students' problems, they try to solve it. It is worth noting that professional development between the resource teachers and the remote teachers has been developed through social media, as I mentioned earlier. By communicating through Facebook and email, they form a network of teachers teaching the same subject. They share lesson plans, teaching materials, activities, resources, ideas, and suggestions. Teachers in remote areas even share their students' work as instructed by resource teachers. And resource teachers will make sure they show this work in the following broadcast lesson. This is very stimulating when remote students see their work on the television. It is evident that resource teachers and remote teachers are working as a team to ensure quality education for their students. And you can see from the PowerPoint, from the slides, these are the Facebook, what's going on in the Facebook among the resource teachers and the remote teachers. They share the pictures of their students being engaged in learning. They share the teaching materials. They share the students' homework. They share the teaching methods. They give suggestions. So it's a learning community going on here on social media, thanks to the technology. As for the remote students, it is clearly seen that remote students perform. I would like to show you a clip of remote students, how they react in the classroom, learning from the distance learning television. You can see from this clip that the voice of the teacher was from the television. There's no teacher in that class. The students are on their own, studying with the tele teacher, or in Thai they called Kru Tu. Kru is teacher, Tu is a box, because in the past the shape of the television is just like a box. Kru Tu or tele teacher. And you see how enthusiastic the students are. They react to the teacher, the tele teacher. They raise their hands, they answer the questions. When the tele teacher asks them, what's the answer? And they said, 17, 17. They didn't care whether the tele teacher would hear the answer or not. They just wanted to answer. They just wanted to participate. And this is very fascinating. And you will never see that anywhere but in schools in remote areas in Thailand. So it is clearly seen that remote students' performance has significantly improved. They are more eager and more motivated to learn with both teachers and students in parent school. They find the lesson more interesting when studying with other teachers and with different teaching methods. They find the classroom environment more stimulating when having students in parent school study alongside them. They sometimes imitate what students in parent school are doing and sometimes compete with them when working in class. This can be seen as a rich learning environment enabling better learning outcome. And this is how our students can grow into a lifelong learner because they never stop learning. They are eager to learn. They are motivated by what they see on the distance learning television, which is part of the technology that helps enable education in Thailand. Thank you.
การศึกษาทางไกลผ่านดาวเทียมหรือ DLTV วันนี้จะพาคุณไปรู้จักกับห้องเรียนที่ผู้เรียนมีส่วนร่วมในการเรียนรู้ด้วยตนเองหรือที่เรียกว่า Active Learning
พอเริ่มเข้าห้องเรียนเนี่ยเด็กๆเขาก็จะดูตารางสอนเขาจะจำได้เลยว่าตารางเรียนวันนี้เนี่ยเรียนวิชาอะไรชั่วโมงที่1ชั่วโมงที่2ชั่วโมงที่3นะคะเขาจะเตรียมอุปกรณ์เลยเตรียมเปิดทีวีเตรียมอะไรไว้รอคุณครูเรื่องนี้เนี่ยเขาจะให้นักเรียนได้รู้เกี่ยวกับป้ายต่างๆเดี๋ยวเราจะได้เรียนไปพร้อมกับคุณครูวิไลพร
ใครจะเห็นป้ายแบบนี้บ้างยกมือ
ใครเห็นยกมือแรกๆเนี่ยเด็กเขาไม่ค่อยสนใจแต่พอครูได้รับการกระตุ้นจากทางคุณครูต้นทางทางคุณครูปลายทางเด็กเขาก็เริ่มสนุกกับการเรียนเหมือนกับเรียนกับคุณครูจริงๆน่ะ
ปัจจุบันนี้นะครับเด็กเริ่มมีความชื่นชอบชื่นชมใน DLTV พอถึงเวลาเรียนปุ๊บเนี่ยเขาจะมีความกระตือรือร้นที่อยากจะเรียนกับครูต้นทางโดยที่มีครูปลายทางของเราเนี่ยเป็นพี่เลี้ยงคอยเสนอแนะต่างๆเวลาเขามีปัญหาเขาก็ถามครูต้นทางแต่ครูต้นทางเขาไม่สามารถตอบให้ได้เพราะว่าเป็นการสื่อสารทางเดียวนะครับครูปลายทางเขาก็จะตอบคำถามแทนเด็ก
เด็กถ้าสนใจสิ่งไหนแล้วเนี่ยมันจะทำให้เด็กเรียนรู้ได้อย่างลึกซึ้งถ้ามีสิ่งเล้ามีสิ่งกระตุ้นจะเป็นรูปแบบวิธีการหรือจะเป็นสื่ออะไรก็แล้วแต่เด็กจะเกิดความสนใจผมเชื่อว่า DLTV เนี่ยกระตุ้นให้เด็กเกิดความสนใจในชั่วโมงเรียน
เลขลบเป็นอย่างไรลบคำให้น้อยลงมา
DLTV ไม่ได้เน้นเพียงให้ผู้เรียนได้เรียนรู้เนื้อหาวิชาจากการฟังเพียงอย่างเดียวแต่ยังมุ่งเน้นให้ผู้เรียนได้เรียนรู้จากการอ่านการเขียนโต้ตอบและคิดวิเคราะห์ฝึกทักษะซึ่งกระบวนการต่างๆเหล่านี้จำเป็นต้องได้รับความร่วมมือและประสานการทำงานร่วมกันของครูต้นทางและครูปลายทางเพื่อให้ผู้เรียนมีส่วนร่วมในการเรียนรู้พร้อมทั้งสร้างความรู้นั้นด้วยตนเอง
ถ้าจะให้เป็น active learning จริงๆนะคะครูปลายทางจะต้องรู้ว่าแต่ละชั่วโมงนะครูต้นทางเขาจะสอนอะไรแล้วสิ่งที่สำคัญก็คือครูปลายทางจะต้องเตรียมสิ่งที่ครูต้นทางเขาจะสอนในชั่วโมงนั้นนะคะอย่างเช่นถ้ามีแบบฝึกก็จะต้องเตรียมแบบฝึกให้เด็ก
นับเป็นการสร้างโอกาสในการเรียนรู้ยกระดับการเรียนการสอนให้มีประสิทธิภาพของการศึกษาทางไกลผ่านดาวเทียมเปิดโอกาสให้ผู้เรียนมีส่วนร่วมต่อการเรียนรู้คิดเป็นทำเป็นรู้จักแก้ปัญหาจากการได้ลงมือปฏิบัติทำให้ผู้เรียนจำความรู้ได้แม่นและนานกว่าการเรียนแบบท่องจำเกิดความคิดสร้างสรรค์ใหม่ๆจากกิจกรรมที่ทำความร่วมมือของครูต้นทางไปสู่ครูปลายทางจะช่วยเปลี่ยนให้ห้องเรียนเดิมๆกลายมาเป็นห้องเรียนมีชีวิตให้กับนักเรียนทุกคน